Hello, it's Thursday, March the 4th. There'll be an episode of Fun Facts Friday tomorrow for you to enjoy. Today we are in Psalm 140. We are almost through the book of Psalms already. And Psalm 140 is a psalm that is cited by the Apostle Paul in the third chapter of Romans. And you will recall that in chapters 2 and the first half of chapter 3 of Romans, before he begins to expound on the great doctrine of justification by faith, Paul gives an expose of sin, original sin and actual sin. And he quotes 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 verses from the Old Testament that speak of our depravity, our fallenness. And verse 3 of this psalm, under their lips is the venom of asps, for example. That's quoted in Romans 3. So it's a psalm that first of all is open and honest about the nature of our sinfulness, the nature of our guilt, both Adamic guilt, that we are guilt, we sin because we are sinners, because we are born sinners. We are born with a propensity and a proclivity to sin. And then a personal appeal comes. I say to the Lord, you are my God. Give ear to the voice of my pleas for mercy, O Lord. And then in verses 9, through 11, it changes. As for the head of those who surround me, let the mischief of their lips overwhelm them. Let burning coals fall upon them. Let them be cast into fire, into miry pits, no more to rise. Let not the slanderer be established in the land. Let evil hunt down the violent man speedily. What do you do with that? Well, first of all, this is David. This is a psalm of David, and David isn't perhaps speaking here personally. He's speaking as the king. And not just the king, but he's also the judge. And in part, what he's saying is what we all desire. We want justice to be done and to be seen to be done. That the punishment ought to fit the crime, an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth, often taken out of context, but what it means is that the punishment shouldn't exceed the crime. It should be a measure of the crime. And so the psalm is asking for peace and stability and justice and equity in the land. What we pray for when we pray for the powers that be. We pray for the president, we pray for Senate, Congress, we pray for the governor, the mayor of this city, we pray for judges, to do their work according to the standards of God's law. And I think that's what essentially this is asking. This is a king seeking justice. Well, Psalm 140, next Monday we'll be back in Psalm 141. Fun Facts Friday tomorrow. Have a wonderful weekend and Lord's Day, and I'll see you again on Monday.
We hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, and you want to make sure you get all of our content, not just videos, but podcasts and ministry updates, make sure you download our app. If you think you might have missed a video, click on our YouTube channel. A link should be down below. There you can see all of our videos. And if you want to make sure you don't miss anything in the future, hit subscribe. If you want to be one of the first ones to know when we release a video, hit that little bell icon. And if this video has blessed you, and you can think of someone else that it might help, use that share icon and send it to them. All, of course, for the edification of God's people and the glory of His name. Until next time, God bless.